It's Windows 10 actually.
Huh?
With one magic file, you can transform Windows 10 into Windows 7.
Are you sure about that?
Take a look at these. Pretty cool, right? Let's take a look at the installation. Remember that this transformation pack only works on version 18.09 and you have to update the OS to at least the January 2023 quality update, not feature update. But in this case, I'll just pause the update temporarily for this video. As this is made by I'm Sword King, now goes by I'm Sword Queen, the same person who created the Windows 8 to 7 transformation pack along with these people. The transformation goes through the same kind of process. Agreeing to license agreement, you get to choose between these three options, such as the branding, which I chose Windows 10, the ribbon style, and the start menu between Status Pack Plus+, and OpenShell. But I can only choose Status Pack Plus+, as OpenShell isn't available due to the transformation pack's early development state. So in the future, perhaps the OpenShell option will be available. Here you can choose the transparency glass option, and you have the option to either keep the automatic color, chocolate color, or both. Here is the final phase of customization options such as theming service patching, using UX theme patcher, patching shell 32.dll, adding the Windows 7 user account control panel applet, calculator, games, gadgets, task manager, Windows Media Center, and bringing back the old administrative option or Windows X shortcut. After this, the computer will go through four phases of transformation. The first phase is preparing the files, the second phase installing programs, third phase registry tweaks, and fourth phase file replacement. After that, you'll be greeted by the Windows 10 lock screen with the Windows 7 background. Oh, and also the startup sound. Here we are on the desktop, and you can see that the interface except the desktop background has already transformed into Windows 7. The recycle bin icon is replaced, the taskbar was amalgamated from Windows 7 and Windows 10 with the Windows 7 look, such as the larger taskbar icons, whilst maintaining the action center. The sound and date and time flyouts are both replaced with Windows 7s, whilst the network flyout is still Windows 10s. Getting started is recreated, only lacking animations, which don't affect the usage of it. The start menu is fully Windows 7 styled thanks to Status Pack Plus+. As you can see, the File Explorer is transformed with Old Unix Explorer and changed MS styles. The icon of system files and some executables have been changed to Windows 7's icon, and trust me, if I offer this OS for the first time, you won't realize that it's Windows 10 actually. The arrow title bar in here is pretty resembling Windows 7's by using Aero Glass, which is pretty awesome. But what about themes? All pre-bundled Windows 7 themes as well as 9 regular themes are installed in here, replacing the Windows 10's themes. The sound scheme is technically present in here, but if you look at the sound setting, it won't appear as it only appears when it's practically triggered. Oh, don't forget about the sampler media. Anyway, UWP apps such as settings in this case partially supports the Windows 7 window layout. But since UWP was built on a different foundation from a Win32 app, only the window borders will appear with the Windows 7 look. But if you take a look at the Win32 app, all of the MS style components such as scrollbar, combo box, text box, button, etc. are carefully changed to the Windows 7 look. Windows 7 games are present as what I demoed in here. Windows 7 gadgets are also present in here, as well as several Windows 7 applications. As this is Windows 10 October 2018 update or 18.09, you can install some modern applications as some of them still support this Windows 10 version, such as VirtualBox, LightShot, and AbbeyWord. Microsoft Store applications can also be installed in here, such as Netflix and Spotify. But do note that the other side of UWP applications aren't well supporting Windows 10 version 18.09, such as WhatsApp, Disney Plus, and Messenger, as all of those requires at least Windows 10 version 19.03. Windows 10 features are also kept in here, such as Task View, Search, and Enhanced Aero Snap, which is an advantage over Windows 7. But as a reminder that all things aren't all perfect, this transformation leaves some minus point, as this version of the transformation pack is still early. The title text in some applications using custom themes are still in white. The window animation still bears the Windows 10 animation. The Windows branding is still there in WinVer if the installed language isn't English United States. Windows Media Center is missing due to its unsupported state in Windows 10. Windows DVD Maker isn't working properly. AltTab in my case is still Windows 10. And things that aren't noticeable here. But don't worry, I'm Sod Quing and her associates are going to update this transformation pack throughout the time for the better, so stay tuned for that. You can check out the transformation pack and download it, the link will be in the description. If you want to see the Sun Valley that we actually want, then check out this video. Meanwhile, like, share, and subscribe. Thank you for my supporter for making this video possible, and also don't forget to check out this video.